Today we're going to be doing this little koala bear. We're going to be using a little bit different technique. We're going to be using a sponge, we're going to use our canvas board. We're going to choose either, you could either use a regular sponge and tear it apart, or what I'm going to be using is what they call a sea sponge. You can buy smaller products like this at Michael's and different Hobby Lobby stores. And I'm just going to be mixing up some fluid acrylics with my browns, a little bit of orange, and a little bit of yellow ochre. We're just going to lay this in, trying to fill it up as much as possible. This can get a little messy. We're going to let that dry. Here's the reference photo we're going to be using. And once again, here are the colors that I'm actually using to put on the board right now for the background. There will be a list at the end of this video with the products that I used today. This is the second coat. Let that dry. For the third coat, I mixed in a little bit of the sap green with my browns and oranges and yellows. Here you can see where I've mixed it together with just mixing it in with the sponge. Okay. Started to do the tree trunk with the sponge. A lot easier just to go over to the brush and lay in the just browns and sap green to get some of the bases in for the tree trunk. All that's done. I'd actually sat this on my lap and drew it out first, but I couldn't see it once I put it on the camera. So I'm going back over it with the chalk pencil to give kind of the outline of where the koala bear is going to sit in this tree. Now we're just going to take black and white. We're going to make some different gray tones. And we're going to use our fluid body acrylics. These are just Hobby Lobby type of acrylics from Anita's. Once again, there will be a list at the end of the video of different products that I used. You can see how some of the tone that I pick up has got a little bit more white in it, or if I want a little bit more white, I just add some. just blocking in most of the whole image, but with tones. So we're going to have different tone values of this gray. And this area, I end up look like I picked up a little bit of the green that was on my palette. That's okay. It's still a gray tone with a kind of a tint of green along the belly. And that actually will help add to some of the depth. Can actually see how much lighter, once it dries, the acrylic dries, how much lighter it is, how much lighter it becomes. So this particular technique is just layer on top of layer. Can see how light that nose has become already after it's dried. So I go back in with more straight black. Now I'm going to just add in here, this is for the tree trunk. We're going to add in some sap green and the black and brown and make a dark tone to deepen up and darken that tree. I don't have a lot on the tree in this video. It's basically just going from dark on the underside to a little bit lighter on the top side. Once I get all that in, I go back over with some yellow ochres and do a little bit of highlights in different areas. Okay, now we're back to the panda. Here, after we've let that black dry, I just throw in a little bit of watered down kind of orange tone in his eyes. I just don't want it too bright, but I want it the color tone there. Then you'll see that I'll add a little bit of yellow ochre to the one side of the eye, and then blend that in. Here you can see that I'm using the liner brush for a little bit more of the finer details that are around the eyes, the nose, the mouth, that type of thing. Then I switch over to what I call my fur brush. I'm not happy with how it's coming out. So I switch over to my fan brush to get some of these darker tones on the underside of the fur also in there. And don't worry if you get things too dark with acrylics. What's wonderful about them is you can go right back over top of anything without having to wait too long. Now, a lot of this is just very slight little dabs to create that texture in the hair. And I don't have a lot of paint on my brush. As you can see, I haven't filled my brush again. Now this, I actually had a little bit too bright, but that's okay. With too bright, we can just go back in and add a little bit more of the blue and black and tone it down and spread it around for the nose. Highlight. I want to take the edges of that highlight and blur it out just a little bit with a dry brush. Now we go back to the eye because we lose the iris of the eye, and I'm just laying back in the black center section of the eye. Here, there's a little bit of blue in my brush when I added that into that highlight of the eye. We'll go back in on top of that blue later and add a little tiny dab of white. Now, what's on my fan brush here is not straight white. This is got a little bit of yellow ochre or a little touch of brown in it just to cream it down a little bit. So this is our first layer of that fuzzy fur all over the little koala bear. Once again, just to remind you, there's very little paint on my brush, and it's very fluid, so it should be very, very subtle. Thank you. dry. And with just a little bit more of a yellow tone through here. Go back in with more of a straight white.